algorithm and flowchart. In our daily life, we receive some commands and give instructions to execute any work. It doesn't matter whether the work is small, as we get up early in the morning or switching on a computer system. We only work as per instructions and commands that are given to us. Likewise, when your mother asks you to bring a vegetable from the market, does she simply ask you to bring the vegetables or gives you detailed step-by-step instructions? Something similar to this: take money from the purse, open the door, go to the market, look for your required vegetables, purchase it as needed, come back to home. It would always be easier to find the file when detailed instructions are given. Giving detailed set of instructions is always important because it enables you to get a clear understanding of what, motive, how, process, problems, interventions. Let us take an example. Suppose you have to buy a pencil from the local stationery shop. Here are the instructions. Go to the stationery shop. Ask for pencils. If pencils are available, take that and make payment for the same. If they are not available, then check any other stationery shop. Return to home. So, detailed step-by-step instruction to perform a task is commonly known as the algorithm. The algorithm can be popularly written for the motive of performing a task along with its objective and all the possible scenarios. Any algorithm is a good algorithm if it contains finite number of steps, no repetition of steps, desired solutions to the problem, defined set of inputs and variables. Need for algorithm. You must be aware that computer works smartly, but it is not able to do any work of its own. Computer needs instructions for carrying out each task. For performing every task on the computer, you need to give well-defined step-by-step instructions, taking into account all the possible situations or problems that might come up during the execution of the computer system. With the help of algorithms, we can easily create such detailed instructions. This is the reason why before developing a software, algorithm should be developed before. So, algorithms help the computer programmer in making a list of instructions that must be given to the computer to perform any task. Example of algorithms. Algorithm 1. Write an algorithm to prepare a cup of tea. Step 1. Put the tea bag in a cup. Step 2. Fill the kettle with water. Step 3. Boil the water in the kettle. Step 4. Pour some of the boiled water into the cup. Step 5. Add milk to the cup. Step 6. Add sugar to the cup. Step 7. Stir the tea. Step 8. Drink the tea. Algorithm 2. Write an algorithm to purchase a t-shirt up to Rs. 250 from a garment store. Step 1. Get money from parents. Step 2. Go to a garment store. Step 3. Ask for the t-shirt of your size. Step 4. If the t-shirt is available, ask for the price. Step 5. If the price is less than or equal to 250, go to step 6, else go to step 9. Step 6. Ask for the price. Step 7. Give money. Step 8. Take a t-shirt. Step 9. Go home. Although real-life examples are good to understand how an algorithm works, algorithms find the most common uses in solving mathematical and computer problems. In terms of computers, algorithms are also defined as a step-by-step procedure to solve a problem. Algorithm 3. Write an algorithm to input username and say hello. Step 1. Start. Step 2. Ask for the name. Step 3. Save name in variable n. Step 4. Display hello n. Step 5. Stop. Let us learn some more complex examples of the algorithm. Algorithm 4. write an algorithm to check the greatest number. Step 1. Start. Step 2. Enter two numbers, num1 and num2. Step 3. Check if num1 is greater than num2. Go to step 4, else go to step 6. Step 4. Display num1 is greater. Step 5. Go to step 8. Step 6. Display num2 is greater. Step 7. Stop. Let us now complicate the same algorithm a little more by introducing a third number. Algorithm 5. Write an algorithm to enter three numbers and then print the largest number among the three. Step 1. Start. Step 2. Enter three numbers, num1, num2 and num3. Step 3. Check if num1 is greater than num2. Go to step 4, else go to step 7. Step 4. Check if num1 is greater than num3. Go to step 5, else go to step 7. Step 5. Display num1 is the largest. Step 6. Go to step 11. Step 7. Check if num2 is greater than num3. Go to step 8, else go to step 10. Step 8. Display num2 is the largest. Step 9. Go to step 11. Step 10. Display num3 is the largest. Step 11. Stop. The above steps are a bit complicated. Imagine the difficulty of reading even bigger problems. There is an easier form of depicting the same step-by-step procedure graphically in the form of flowcharts. Let us now learn what flowcharts are. Flowcharts. A flowchart is a diagrammatic representation of a sequence of logical steps of an algorithm. As we use the English language to show step-by-step procedures in the algorithm, flowcharts can be displayed in simple shapes to depict processes and data flow in the computer program. Flowchart symbols. The following list displays the most commonly used flowchart symbols. Symbol. Use. Start, stop box. It is used in the beginning and ending of the flowchart. Input-output box. It is used for accepting inputs or giving output of the program. Processing box. It is used for writing the processing instructions and doing calculations. Decision box or condition box. It is used for checking or applying any condition in the program. Flow lines. Flow lines show the direction in which the control of the program is moving. These arrows are used to connect the various geometrical symbols in a flowchart. On-page connector. These are used to connect one part of the flowchart to another. Let us create flowcharts for the algorithms written till now. Flowchart 1. Draw a flowchart to prepare a cup of tea. Start. Put the tea bag in a cup. Fill the kettle with water. Boil the water in the kettle. Pour some of the boiled water into the cup. Add milk, sugar to the cup. Strain it in a cup and serve the hot tea. Stop. Flowchart 2. Make a flowchart to input username and say hello. Start. Take name from user. Message hello name. Stop. Flowchart 3. Make a flowchart to enter two numbers and then tell which the larger number is. Start. Enter num1 and num2. Display num1 is larger. Yes. Is num1 greater than num2? No. Display num2 is larger. Stop. Flowchart 4. Write an algorithm to enter three numbers and then tell which the largest number is. Start. Enter num1 and num2. Is num1 greater than num2? Yes. Is num2 greater than num3? No. Is num2 greater than num3? Display num3 is larger. Display num1 is largest. Display num2 is largest. Stop.